Yo, what up, everybody? I'm Akeem LaWanson, and in today's Fix of Entertainment News, the internet has opinions about the surprise casting of Mario, a fan-favorite showrunner returns to the Doctor Who franchise, and a fresh new look at the cast of Netflix's Cowboy Bebop. Let's drop it. Nintendo's latest Nintendo Direct hit us all with a surge of mixed emotions with some of the announcement drops. Like, we all laughed at Kirby seemingly finding his way into The Last of Us, cried upon seeing the Bayonetta 3 trailer, and were shocked at the casting of Illumination's upcoming Mario animated movie. America's favorite sweetheart, Chris Pratt, will be voicing our little plumber boy, and the internet is already running wild with the photoshopped memes reacting to the news. Even Chris Pratt himself responded to the announcement of him being Mario. Here's what he had to say.
So when I was a kid, I lived in Lake Stevens, Washington, and there is this coin-operated laundromat near my house, and it had Super Mario Brothers, the original arcade game. Oh, I loved that game. I never had a quarter. It felt like I'd either steal him from the wishing well, you know, I'd steal. That's wild. Just dawned on me right now. The quarter I stole out of the wishing well to play Super Mario Brothers has come true that I get to be the voice of Mario. But I clearly stole someone else's wish. So just waiting for that row of karma dominoes to come crashing down on me. But as it is right now, it's a me, a Mario. That's not the voice. You'll have to wait to hear the voice, but we've been working hard at it, and I'm really excited to announce that I'm going to be the voice of that video game that I dreamed about playing as a kid. Dreams come true.
Aw, yeah, dreams do indeed come true, but your dream, Mr. Pratt, was to play Super Mario Brothers, the video game, not to play Super Mario in an animated movie. That's just way too specific of a dream for a kid to have back then. You know, that's just Chris Pratt's way of trying to be inspiring by telling a story of when he was a kid and to make it seem as if the universe somehow answered a wish he made by stealing someone else's wish, like a wish succubus? Anyway, this casting sure did lead to a slew of online memes from many of the denizens of the internet. The meme lords came out in droves, busting out images of Pratt as Star-Lord, him in Jurassic World, and I believe I saw one from the Tomorrow War, aptly renamed the Tomario War. Yeah, that was clever. Now, one bit that didn't sit right with a few fans is that Charles Martinet, the guy who voiced Mario in several video games since the 90s, will pop up in the movie in surprise cameos as opposed to just voicing the titular character in the film over Pratt. Now, I can understand why some might be upset about that, you know, but this is a feature film. You know, Mario's going to have to show a range of emotions not seen in the video games. Voice acting for a video game is different from voice acting for an animated feature film. You know, not to mention, attaching a star-studded cast to a project of this size is one way of assuring butts fill them seats in theaters. Now, that's not to take anything away from Martinet. You know, he was an actor long before he landed the coveted role of Mario. Now, you and I both know as gamers who Charles Martinet is, but Chris Pratt is a household name. Like, your mama knows who that is. Like, with the Marvel movies and the Jurassic World films, far more folks know who he is than the name of the guy who voiced Mario since we were kids. While Chris Pratt as Mario is, I'm not gonna lie, it's a bit of an interesting one, to say the least. We'll have to wait and see how he's going to pull off voicing one of the most iconic video game characters in history. Hopefully he's as cool as Miyamoto-san thinks he is. Now, rounding out the cast is Anya Taylor-Joy as Peach, Charlie Day as Luigi, Jack Black as Bowser, Keegan-Michael Key as Toad, Fred Armisen as Cranky Kong, and Seth Rogen as Donkey Kong. So does that mean we're gonna be getting DK doing that Seth Rogen laugh? Oh, that's gonna be dope. I can't wait to hear that. Now, Illumination's Super Mario Brothers movie is set to release December 21st, 2022. Now, in other news, Doctor Who fans rejoice, y'all rejoice. The BBC announced Russell T. Davies will be returning to the series as showrunner for the show's 60th anniversary. Now, Davies will be returning when they hit that anniversary milestone in 2023 and beyond, according to the BBC. Davies was responsible for bringing Doctor Who back to life in 2005 after it had been off the air for over 15 years. Exciting stuff for the long-running sci-fi series. And finally, here's a new look at the cast of Netflix's Cowboy Bebop from the back. Now, in this poster, you see the members of the Bebop on a desolate planet, guns drawn, and honestly looking more like their anime counterparts from this particular angle. Now, with the swordfish spaceship in the sky, the poster is teasing the Cowboy Bebop opening sequence, which is set to drop at Netflix's special fan event, Ta-Dum, happening Saturday at 9 a.m. Pacific time. Now, be on the lookout for that if you're excited for this one. November 19th can't come any sooner. I'm so excited for this one. And that was your entertainment fix for today. I'm Akeem LaWanson. Thank you all so much for watching. Now that you're all caught up on the news, check out what Daniel Craig thinks about the idea of a female James Bond. Download the IGN app on all your devices, and for everything else, keep it locked right here on IGN.
Rob.